bitch.
It's kind of fun to shoot it like this. You out of here, Drew?
Yeah, see you next year.
See you on Christmas.
See how hard you can get lost.
Be safe out there. Let me know if you need us to come save you.
Bye.
We just bit our friend Drew.
Stirring up the potion. He looks so good. Get it in the right light. It's like the purple slushy or some deep purple, dark purple.
You can't tell, I still don't take caffeine.
Why is that?
The risk to reward is not beneficial, I feel like. Cause, like, when I'm working out, I just start tweaking out if I have caffeine in me, so. I'd rather have a slow start to my workout and then have a good pump than just be like,
all right, feeling sick.
Also, it does make me feel sick after. If you don't take caffeine, like moi, that's when we use the nitric. So it's basically everything that the regular mode has, but no caffeine. Creatine in here, everything.
Okay, yeah, so if you like caffeine, Gorilla just did this new, their new mode. They said they got rid of the chalkiness. They said it. They made it a lot better. I don't know. We're gonna give it a taste test. I haven't tried it before.
What flavor is it?
Cherry blackout.
I'm not gonna be like Chris Tran and OD has some caffeine right now.
Shout out, my man.
Shout out, man, Chris.
Flash recovery.
Yeah, man.
Biggest bro.
Here we go, man. It's a big. Oh yeah, they said they gave us a bit. It's a bigger scoop in these because it just has more of everything.
It's like a protein scoop.
Bro, that's crazy. How much caffeine's in this shit? 400 mil? Damn, so this is gonna be a 400 milligram workout.
Don't take two scoops.
I'm not gonna do two scoops. This is 400 right here.
No, it's not.
So this is it. One scoop. Caffeine, where is it? Here. Oh, wait. Two scoops. Okay.
So 200. That's not too bad. They got lots of new pump ages and shit in there. Charm for Shizzy and Jizzy.
And Tizzy.
And who?
Tizzy.
Tizzy? And Tim?
Yep.
Alex, what are you doing these days? Should have went on Gorilla, bro. Rise is a fucking L. Anyway, let's go. Cheers, bro. Bro, that's not too bad.
I don't take caffeine.
Oh, dude, you can't taste it.
Bro, really? I just went on a whole spiel about how I don't drink caffeine, and bro, taste
pretty
it.
Good, guys, no kizzy, bro. It's really smooth. I'm not even capping. That's nice. Good job, Derek.
Fuck yeah,
big dick Derek. Shout out. Man.
They know how Canadians rock. What is this stuff called again?
Dry ice.
Holy shit, that's cold.
Yeah, don't touch it with your hand. Don't.
Right. Shit was cold, man. I feel like my skin was about to fold right off. Mm-hmm. Anyway.
Wonder why.
Mega fit. Guys, it's like Christmas, man. Free meals. Aw, Shizzy. No, I'm just kidding. Chicken burrito bowl. Bison burger. Beef kebabs, dude. Honestly, I eat the hell out of these, don't I, bro?
He does.
I like them.
Load it up.
Load her up. Load her up, Niger. You guys don't know this, but we low-key grew up in the sticks. We're country boys.
Grew up in like 10 different places. A lot of moving around. Shout out, Shizzy Dizzy Mom.
Yeah, fine. Shout out, Mom, for never, like, the fucking non-stop hustle. Hustle of the year. That's an OG.
All right, just so you guys don't spam call this person. If you are in the Los Angeles area, that's as general as I can put it, and you see this kitten, Darlu, big white and black guy.
$400.
$400. If you find him, comment, DM us, let us know.
This isn't our cat, by the way.
This isn't our cat, but let's find Darlu. Come on, Shizzy Jizzies, let's go. Oh man, you can't even see with the exposure. Hold up. How bright it is. Alright. Look at that. new kick shoe or new ball kicks, kick balls, some Zions. What y'all think? Is this compy? Let me know. We're at the gym now, ready to
annihilate,
fire off, blast off. But before we do that,
we gotta pray.
Oh, you read my fucking mind. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day, for your blessings and your continued provisions for me, my family, and all my loved ones. And I thank you for this workout that we're about to have, that you can strengthen our bodies, and more than just physically every day, and just really hone our senses and do what we got to do in there, and have a blessed day. Good workout, good pump. Thank you, God. Amen.
Amen. Anyone watching this video, I hope that you feel the presence of God in your life right now. In your room, or wherever you're watching this. Woo! Just so you know, I feel like in bodybuilding, in the industry, it's all about who's the biggest, right? But what if the biggest is a natural? What if we switch the whole game? What if we make people want to be natural? And maximize your natural ability? Because as soon as the AI shit comes out, on these robots start coming out, bro. All
right, you're losing.
I know, but I like, hear me out. A natural body, or fuck your physique, an AI can't replicate that. That is 100% organically yours. An AI can never take away your physique. So, long story short, when AI comes, fucking make sure you have a killer physique, because then you'll, you know what I mean? Your job will be secure. Can we just fucking get out of here?
Fit check.
Fit check. You got the body butter shirts, huh? The E6 with the YoungLA socks. This just dropped. Stretchy floral skull tee. Got the YoungLA bandana. This is coming soon. Let me see you.
Nike.
Okay.
Oh.
Woo! Don't sleep on him.
Break the business.
Yep, talk to me.
I'll be that guy that forgets deodorant.
You're that guy?
Fucking guy today. It smells. Take a whiff.
No.
Do it.
I'm not sticking with it. You're gonna take a whiff. I am not taking a whiff of that.
It's bad. Trust me. I'm really fucking bad. I didn't even start working out yet, so.
Air that bitch out, bro. You gotta air it out.
Try for the foam. Let's go.
You dirty.
Come on.
Yep, up, yep. Let's go. Down and up. Up.
Let's go.
Tempo. Come on.
Yep.
Oh. All you.
Yep.
Let's go.
One more.
Yep. Yep.
Yep.
All the way up. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
Yeah.
Woo. And moving.
These people would have hit that.
Yep. Come on. Get dirty with it. Yep. Nice. Yep. Tell him,
huh?
Tell him what happens when you neglect your rear delts.
You get that mudslide.
Mudslide.
You get that mudslide back. You go. The front looks great, like a cliff face, and then nothing.
Drift to the ground. So after this, one more set, we gotta hit some rear delts because I was gonna mention it in the car when we were talking about posture.
Oh, yeah.
Rear delts actually help your posture a lot. Fun fact. So if you guys want to get taller, get them mudslides up.
No mudslides.
Fire print, bro. Good shit. See ya, man. I turned into Papa Smurf. Oh, Papa Smurf looking crazy. Oh, yeah.
You can see the front delt's really pumped right now. Front delt's got pretty full, so the rear delt, we got a cranker.
Right there. Rear delt. No, we don't need another audio.
Get ready to the meat and potatoes, bro. Let's go hit some biceps. I said, I feel like I look like a hot dog.
What kind of fucking hot dog looks like that?
Michael Hearn, where you at?
Closing the bay doors is getting a little too breezy in here. Yeah. Brother just finishes what?
My intro workout, yeah. After shoulder. Like if you got like a 2 day like back and biceps, it's I like to do like I say I finish back, I'll drink my intra and hit biceps. Just so I get a little extra oomph for your workout.
Hell yeah.
All that show them what you're holding.
Oh.
my Instagram to ask us questions for this YouTube. Shout out Aki Blasian.
He asked, do you miss me, Stinkabutt?
I do miss you a lot, Pearson. We both do. We love you. This next set is for you. No, actually, I lied. This next set is for the creator of Dragon Ball Z. Fuck you, Pearson.
Dude, this camera's getting hard to hold with these pump right now.
Get active! Come on. Top three, Warzone. You got two teams above you. What are you doing?
Stay in your corner.
Then what?
Where's the circle going?
South. You're north.
I gotta rotate left.
Come on. The other two teams wanted more. The teams wanted more. Come on.
Sweet.
Got one more kill. Come on. Warzone references during a workout? It's fucking insane. Lodi drop.
That's just the bodies. Right, we're on the tries. 21s maybe. Maybe 21s right now. We don't know yet.
Let's do a little update on our cut.
Bro, honestly, yeah. I found this like really... I was in the mirror.
Oh. What's that say?
241.
241.2.
Three pounds?
In about a week.
Nice. That's good. That's actually good.
Yeah, but you don't want to do it too fast.
Mm-hmm.
So flat. Flat standing. You're in the book.
Oh, yeah.
What are we doing?
I don't know.
Come on!
Cable. What would you call these?
Cable curls? Looking fucking massive. Come on. You're not looking big enough. Let's go.
Beautiful thing about these. It works for your brachialis. I'm gonna point to where I think that is. It's like a hammer curl, so it's kind of worse than the thickness instead of just the peak. The peak is nice, but you got a skinny fucking bicep. Like SpongeBob.
And we're trying to get like who?
Larry the Crab.
Larry the Crab.
We got the Larry the Crab physique. Cannon. Come on. Yep.
The amount of pump you can get with a controlled, the amount of pump you can get with a controlled set.
Controlled what?
A controlled set. See how controlled that was?
You see a bicep pump.
Nice.
It all comes together. Biceps are
are officially done, but check this out. It's like a piece of meat. Just sitting there.
Wow. Nice.
Time to hit the trizzies.
Yo, just so you know, guys, triceps takes up 2/3 of your arm. So if you want to grow big arms, you got to get triceps. Look at this guy over here. Getting after it, doing his own thing. Love to see it. Nice.
Get it down. Transforming. It's a Mr. Olympia. Not there yet.
Is looking too big right now? Is looking way too big?
Fucking just bit the rope. Fucking problem.
This shit. Rabbit dog.
What is that?
Oh, so good. I should do a stretching one though.
Show that new pose.
Just to hide the bulk.
Derek,
what?
Say that again. I was saying, like, I was just telling Samuel, I was like, yo, actually, like, it's a real shit. Like, that pre-workout wasn't chalky at all.
Sorry,
wasn't chalky at all.
Yo, this Toyota, man, this shit goes. Don't let me press that sport button. But yes, so I was saying, like, the mode, it's actually not chocolate. I didn't feel sick to my stomach. Sometimes when I take the mode, like I take a double scoop or even a single scoop, sometimes that messes with my stomach. But right now, I'm good. I feel good. Not even like didn't crash at all. You know, energy was consistent throughout the workout. Stomach feels fine, man. Good shit, Garrick. Good shit, Derek.
Garrick.
Good shit, Garrick. Also, be obsessed with your own progress. Don't get caught up in like online social media physiques and stuff. Honestly, guys, just like go at your own pace. Push yourself to where you can push yourself. Eventually, you're going to get bigger. You're going to get stronger. But honestly, just like we growing up, we didn't have big arms. We worked for it. We worked really hard for it. We've done the work, you know? So like when you look at us, don't get discouraged if you guys aren't as big as us because we've been doing it for longer. So just be obsessed with your own talent. Be obsessed with your own progress and just keep chasing your goals.
What he said about the online shit. Like nobody ever shows what they look like when they roll out of bed. So I'm looking like cold clay, man, when I wake up.
Tell you what, I got a film of fat covering my entire body.
So we're only showing you the good parts. Yeah, like
I would love to wake up and just show you guys my physique, but I'd probably fucking just die inside because I just look so mid. It's normal. I wake up, I look like shit. I'm not gonna lie. I look in the mirror, I'm like, huh?
You know?
That also could be some sort of body dysmorphia.
So. No, I got body dysmorphia bad. Yeah. It's bad right now. Yeah. Real bad.
We all do. Pretty pussy, come here.
Strong, furry
little thing. Pretty little thing. Petite little thing. Big yawn. Oh my god, she just looks so cute.
That was fun for the 2 seconds it lasted.
Good pump, good everything, I'd say.
With an arm workout, it's kind of weird because you don't know what, there's nothing else to flex but your arms, you know? Or I was watching a cat on the
She's so pretty, sorry.
Drink some of this protein.
Not him.
And we're going to answer some of the questions that you guys slid up and asked me on my story. So stay tuned for that. We're actually going to do it directly after this. You already know what we're drinking. Gorizzy nuts. Right down the throat.
Mm-hmm.
She does look pretty right now.
Especially on the camera, bro. Her eyes. Low-key, we turned into housewives with cats. We do nothing but tend to our kittens and eat.
I don't know where I'd be without these kittens. Life's been hard lately.
That guy.
Their protein? If it wasn't for these guys, I don't know where I'd be.
Johnny Bird asks, when will you compete? So this is for both of us, so you can go first.
Well, definitely competing in July and October. I have two shows. One's the WNBF show in California, and then I have the Natural Ohio NPC show in October.
I don't have one picked out yet. Well, probably be ending up around the regions of August, September, October. That's what I would guess. Going in men's physique. I'm not doing that shit. Classic. Even if I get blown out in the water, you know, pushes me to, you know, bring my legs up and stuff. So I'm going to do classic. Thank you, Johnny.
Mm-hmm.
Jackson Jarrett says, is posting your physique online vain? I feel like it can be if your intentions are only posting it for reasons like I want a woman to obsess over how I look, or, you know, opposite, I want men to obsess over how I look. So it's kind of like if you're posting anything in more of an informational way, I guess, or just like inspiring way, then in that sense, I feel like it's not vain. But if you're only, the only outcome you see is to like get gratification, then I feel like yes, it can be vain.
So it's kind of a tricky question because I feel like there's a fine line between being proud of your progress and also just posting for like attention, you know?
Like I post online, it's kind of like a journal. So like I have videos from when I was like 180 pounds, stuff like that. Yeah. And like if I wasn't taking videos and posting online, I wouldn't, you know, have those.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm kind of grateful for it. How has God helped you mentally, physically? It's a good question too. Oh wait, this is from Lucas.
How has God helped us mentally and physically? I think mentally and physically, when I was first starting in the gym, like obviously no one knew who I was. But I remember, like, while I was in the YMCA, like, closing my eyes, even the beginning of my workouts, and, like, just talking to God and closing myself in this room. And, like, God would always, like, someone once told me that God was my biggest supporter. And I believe that applies for everyone, is that God is your number one supporter. When you feel like no one is supporting you or has your back, He does.
And in the gym especially, like when you're trying to work on yourself, it's important that you have like a good heart and mindset behind it. You know, that's like a holistic, it could really change your life. So like when I was in there, like I would close myself mentally in this room, it was just me and God. And it would be like before a PR or something, and I'd be like, God, help me lift this up. And that really did help me like create like a healthy relationship with the weights, because if I didn't hit it, I'm like, all right, well, like I'm optimistic, like, I'm gonna hit it next week. You know, and just keep a positive mindset. Like God really has really had a positive impact on my lifting.
From a mental standpoint, I feel like definitely has helped in terms of like having a small routine in the morning, which I do, which is just praying, like spending time in the Word and praying, has helped me to start my day on like a better note. So if I were to just like just jump right in the day, like without that like comfort, sense of comfort right away from, you know, reading and praying, and my day is already just 10 times more stressful. So I feel like having that sets me on like a good path for the rest of the day. So I mean, it's definitely beneficial to grow your relationship with God if you want to grow all aspects of life, you know, mentally, physically. So he has helped in both, for both of us. All right, top five animes.
Tough.
I'll go.
Okay.
In no order. No order. Jujutsu Kaisen, Hunter x Hunter, JoJo's, Demon Slayer isn't there. Yes, it is. I don't know. I think that's it. I only got a top three.
Missing peak. Naruto, One Piece, Dragon Ball Z. Probably Tokyo Ghoul and Bleach for me. But though Jujutsu Kaisen is up there too, for sure.
And then also, how is the movement from Massachusetts to California? This is from Carlos, by the way.
Carlos, you perceptive motherfucker. It's been tough.
Yeah.
We are not city boys.
Hello?
We're not LA boys.
We talk about this like every other night, or at least I try to, because transition here is very hard.
It's been really hard to like, even like financially living here. It's because it's like
everything's so much more expensive. So like, I've never had the stress like financially in that way. So I've had times where like I'm just not making money, but now you know, I'm making, you know, a good amount of money, but like it's all going into just rent, shit, rent and all that stuff. So it's like, never had to just like spend this amount of money, which I know that sounds privileged as hell, but it's kind of just the situation I'm in right now.
Not a lot of people make it out here though in LA. They come out here because they think they can, but this place has such a spiritual pressure on it, like the spiritual presence, like mentally, like he's saying, like a routine here was so important. Like if you wake up here and you're like on your phone, you know, I don't know, trying to figure out what to do with your day. Like, you're going to meet people, you're going to like get drained, you're not going to spend time with yourself, and then before you know it, you're going to be burnt out and not know where to go, you know?
And it's like, in part, it's weird because it's such like a social city, so someone like me, where I'm a little more introverted, it's kind of hard to find my click. Whereas, like, you know, someone else is like, oh, I need to, you know, feel that comfort of community, I'm just going to go out to a bar or something like that. I can't really do that, so I could, but I'm not going to, because I'm not going to, whatever. So, like, it's just hard to find that groove, I guess, out here. Whereas in, you know, Massachusetts or New York, whatever, I feel like it was kind of a little more easy. It's a simple life, you know? Mm-hmm. So, we're not, you know, we're born Rochester, New York, you know, moved around all the way to Syracuse, Albany, just like little cities, never anything really too big, so we're not used to like...
So even high school was like, we had like nobody in our high school.
Yeah, I graduated with 60 people, if that tells you anything. Transition's going, all right, could be better.
Yeah.
But...
Just staying focused, man, like on the goal, like why did we come here, like what is our goal? You know, like us too, like we've had, this place is really like, refined us into being like, what are we doing here? You know, like that question is, what are we doing here? And we've been talking about it more recently than of late, but definitely gonna start like a merch. We got, oh, perfect. He's got it pulled up. why I'm trying to stay focused on my mission is because I feel like most content creators don't actually live out a bodybuilding lifestyle. It's just the truth, guys. You know, like
iPhone sets.
Dude, telling you, man. Like, we're really doing this shit, and it's like kind of hard to stay focused when people that you're around don't really do this shit. You know what I'm saying?
Kim asked, when is the merch going? Soon. Yeah, say, well, like, within 2 months.
I would say, excuse me.
Do we still thrift? Believe it or not, we do. Loki, the ones around us kind of suck, yeah. But we still love, like, secondhand stores. That's what we, you know, we grew up on. I don't like buying anything off the racks just because it's more expensive. It doesn't have, like, that worn-in look. We definitely still are money conscious, and we don't just, you know, go buy Balenciaga and weird, ugly shit.
Because when you come from the bottom, you got that, they got that drip. That drip's so sick, like a sewer drip. Got that sewer drip.
The thrift drip.
Yeah.
Fuck it, let's do one more. That's from Joe. I'm selling on.
Sorry, Jones.
A lot of questions about when we start working out, but I feel like we've talked about that. If you have a choice to travel to any country you want to go, what will it be? Personally, probably it was hard between Greece, Japan, like Italy, I think. Somewhere in Europe.
Mm.
But Japan is just like, I feel like the culture is really calm. That's kind of why I want to go there, like Kyoto. I feel like I would be so at home there. Just like temples and nature and, you know, soft-spoken people from what I hear. So probably Japan.
I love history, so I feel like I'd do Egypt just to see the pyramids. I feel like that'd be cool. And like any other of the historical, like, you know, monuments or whatever over there. I feel like
Sphinx.
Yeah, it's like cool stuff like that. Like maybe, who knows, I find like a Indiana Jones cavern one day. That's like my childhood dream, bro. It's like tripping on like this imaginary land, bro.
And that question was from Layla.
Leia?
Yeah. Layla. Leia? Thank you for that. I think that was our first Q&A. My lips, you probably saw. Someone count how many times I licked my lips. Because holy crap.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to go get my haircut for the UK, the Arnold UK. I won't be here next week.
Yeah,
we're gonna try to film something for you guys.
Yeah, we might have to film it this weekend or the muscle.
What up?
Hey!
Is that his painting stuff?
Is that a cat?
Harry just killed the cat.
Cat on the loose.
Thank you.
Ready? I'm gonna go chase after one of them.
We'll get him.
Get him, Harry!
Alright, so as we said, next video will be, he will be in the UK.
First time, bro.
Yeah.
I'm kind of pumped. We're going to see if it's all about, like, the tea and the crispies or whatever.
Tea and the crumpets.
Tea and crumpets.
Yep. Him and Harold and Drew are heading there, and old man Sam is staying back.
Watch pulled it. Out the mega fit video. Yeah. Thought it was out.
And I'm going to go get my hair cut.
Yeah. So next week we will be...
he'll try and film some stuff out there, and then mm-hmm.
I'll send it to him in like a Dropbox. We'll do like a UK/LA
yeah.
collab.
It's kind of what we're both doing in that day. Mm-hmm. But yeah, we will see you then.
See you then.
See you then.
Restock YoungLA on the 12th. Big, huge restock on the 12th.
Not in this. Maybe, I don't know. But that's Tuesday. So when you see this,
mm-hmm.
it's coming out tomorrow, Saturday. 3 days from then.
Yep.
But yeah. Always, as always, love ya.
Yeah, man.
Sorry if the energy's been a bit low for me today. Just having one of those days. You know, I like to be real with you guys. But, you know, as I say, fuck it. We'll be alright.
Yep.
Says the Lord.
Where is she? Where is she?
Go get her.
Say bye, guys.
What are these?
Right, guys? Little protein.
Protein and princess.
And guys, the coochie.
Oh, that shit don't count.
The coochie.
Frauds. Bean. Hey, are you peeing?
I am peeing.
Shit.
Come in, dude.
All right, I'm going to slip in your closet. Coochie ain't worth it.